Hey guys, welcome to the fourth video of my series on regex in Python. And in this video, we're going to talk about a very important concept related to regular expressions, which is character classes. So first of all, consider a scenario where in a given text, you want to search for two words, which are license and license, right? So there are two different spellings actually. You have S here, and in other case, you have C here, right? So these are the two differences between them. And now what I want is, I want to search for them. So how will you go about doing that using regex? One way of doing that with what we have done till now is that we can simply write two regular expressions and we can merge the results. That's it. But one other way that can be possible is that at the sixth index, at the sixth position in the pattern that I will write, I can write that I can accept C or S, any of them at this position. How about that? So if I am able to do that, that will be quite interesting and easy to use. So character classes are actually do exactly this. So character classes allow you to define that a character will match at a particular position if any of the defined characters in a given set is present at that position. And in order to define a character class, you have to use square brackets. So let me give an example so that we can get a better understanding. So I'm going to import the RE module, and I'm also importing a utility function, which is called highlight regex matches from the utils module, which I have created in this tutorial GitHub repo, the tutorial package. So this is a function that we are using. This will simply take a pattern and a text, and it will highlight the matches for you. It will highlight them with some colors. So I'm just importing these dependencies. This is my text. As you can see, it contains license three times, 1, 2, and 3. And at two places, the spelling is with a C. And at one place, the spelling is with a S. So now I want to write a pattern so that we can match all of them. So pattern is equal to re.compile. So L-I-C-E-N. So up to L-I-C-E-N, there is no problem in writing the regex expression, the regular expression. But after that, I need to define a character class. A character class means a set of characters which are acceptable at that particular position. So C and S, I am putting in that position, and then I put an E. So what does this mean? It means that it is going to match L-I-C-E-N, and after that, at the sixth position, it will match for any of the characters which are available in this particular character set, which is C or S, right? So pattern.findAll.txt, and look at that, we get all the three spellings, right? So we found all of them. And just to be sure, highlight regex matches, in which I'm gonna pass pattern and the txt. So look at that, we got a match at this position, here and here. So in this way, by using a simple character class in our regex pattern, we were able to create a special pattern which was able to match two different kind of spellings. So here it is, a diagram which will make it easier to understand for you. So L-I-C-E-N are simple literals. After that, we have a meta character, which is square brackets. Square brackets are used to specify character classes or character sets in which we can have multiple characters. And at that particular position, any of those characters can match. So we have C or S, so any of those can match. And after that, we move to E, which is again a literal. So in this way, we have created this nice character class example. So I hope the concept is clear. So let us move on to the next part, which is character set range. So basically, consider that at particular position, you want to match for any kind of digit, right? So for matching the digit, you will have to write 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 every time. So that is quite cumbersome and lengthy. So instead of doing that, you can simply do 0-9. So this is basically a special syntax in which you can just write 0-9, and it is a character set range. A character set range will specify a range, and this mean the same thing. So similarly, we have character set ranges for lowercase alphabets and the uppercase alphabets, like this. And if you want to define all of them in a particular place, so let's say you want to define a character set in which you are going to accept A to Z in lowercase, A to Z in uppercase, 0 to 9 in uppercase, 0 to 9 digits, then you can write it like this. Also, let's say you want to just take A to E, then again you can write it like this, A to E. That is also acceptable. So in this way, we can define different kind of character set ranges. So let us take an example to understand it better. So let's say I have this text, and in this text, I have some years at different places like 2008, 2017 and so on. So let's say I want to match, or I want to find all the years which have been there in this particular input text. So how can I do that? I will have to define a pattern. So my pattern is 0 to 9. Well, an year might start from 1 to 9, I think, because we will never put an year like this 0, 1, 2, 3. That is not a valid year, right? So I'm just gonna make it 1 to 9. And then 0 to 9, again 0 to 9, and again 0 to 9. So what does this mean? It means that in my pattern, I want to search for the first character should be in the range 1 to 9. The second character can be in the range 0 to 9. Third character again 0 to 9. Fourth character again 0 to 9. And this is completely, these four characters will constitute my year. So let us try to find it. Pattern.findAll.txt. Look at that. We got all the years in our text. Let us try to highlight them, pattern and the text. So here you go. So we have got all the years in our text. So in this way, by writing a very simple expression, you are able to find all the years which have been occurred in your input text. So I hope the concept is clear. So let us move on to the next part, which is negating. So you can use a caret symbol just after the square bracket meta character, the enclosing meta character, the opening square bracket basically. So after, just after the square opening square bracket, you can put a caret symbol, and what will it do is that it will make a character set negate itself. So what does this mean is that if you write this A to Z, what does this mean? It means that at this particular position, the character should not be between A to Z. Or if you write 0 to 9 as well, it means that the character should not be between A to Z and 0 to 9. So that is what it means, right? So let's say you want to find all the characters in the text except vowels. So what can you do? You can write a pattern like this. Pattern is equal to re.compile, in which you can pass a character set, in which you can just put a caret and then A-E-I-O-U. So what does this mean? It means that find a match in which we have a character which does not match A-E-I-O-U. So this is quite simple. And if you try to do pattern.findAll.txt, look at that. You will get all the characters, but none of them is one of A-E-I-O-U, right? So you get all the characters except A-E-I-O-U. So in this way, we can do this. And let's say you want to get the text, complete text, then you can do dot join. So you can use a join function of the Python strings, and you can print this result as well to just make it look prettier. So look at that. I have printed my text without any vowels. TH, FRST, SSN. It's looking quite weird, right? But it's quite cool. So in this way, you can remove all the vowels from your text by using a very simple expression. So instead of writing lengthy Python programs, you can use a single line of regex in order to do such kind of complex operations. So I hope the concept of character classes, then the character range, and then the negation of the character classes is clear. Let us move on to the last part, which is predefined character classes. So basically, there are some predefined character classes so that you do not have to write a lot. So the first character class is a dot. A dot means that at that particular position, match any character except new line. So it will match any character except slash n. So if there is slash n, then it will stop. Otherwise, it will match any character at that particular position. Then we have slash small d, which means that at this particular position, match any digit. Slash capital D means match anything except a digit. Slash s means match any white space character, and the white space character can be slash t, which means tab, or it can be slash n, slash r, slash f, slash v, or the space, right? So all these six kind of white spaces are included in it. And then slash capital S is for matching anything except a white space character. Slash W is for matching any kind of alphanumeric character, which includes small a to z, capital A to z, 0 to 9 and underscore. So you can use slash W for matching all of them. So instead of writing this big thing, this complete big thing, you can simply write slash W. Right? So this is kind of a shortcut for you. So let us try to improve our pattern for finding the year in this particular case. So we were writing this thing, right? So let me just copy it. And now let me just improve this pattern. So for 1 to 9, I cannot do much. But for 0 to 9, I know that they can be represented by slash D. So I just put 3 slash D's here. And let us try to see. Pattern dot find all txt. And look at that. We are getting the same result. So I just used slash D instead of writing square bracket 0 to 9. So instead of writing square bracket 0 to 9, I used an alias for it. A predefined character class, which is slash D. Right? Let us take a last example, which is let us try to find out all the special symbols. By special symbols, I mean non-alphanumeric, non-white space. So I want to find all non-alphanumeric and non-white space characters in my text. So what can I do that? What can I do for that? Pattern is equal to re.compile. So I want to find out all the special symbols, right? So I need to make a characters class in which I would like to negate slash W slash S. That's it. So let us try to see. Pattern dot find all txt. Look at that. So what I have done is I have written a character class in which I am negating slash W and slash S. So what does this mean is I am negating all the alphanumeric characters and I am negating or excluding all the white space characters. So in this way, the result that I'm getting is excluding them. So I'm getting all the symbols, you can say, or any kind of special symbol. Yeah. So this is so this covers our total understanding of the character classes. We started with the basic definition of character classes, how to use them, how to put a square bracket around them, where can we use them. Then we moved on to the character set range, how can we define the different kind of ranges. And then we moved on to some predefined character classes that we have here. And then finally, we have learned that they are quite useful. So yeah, so this was all about character classes. If you still have any doubts, you can put them in the comment section below. That's it from this video. Thanks for watching.